For a developing country like ours, the importance of enabling equitable research system in ensuring an inclusive and sustainable development cannot be overstated. It is through research that we continuously test the limits of our knowledge and explore new frontiers of knowledge and innovation. Research is a means of producing, appropriating, and contextualizing knowledge, which is the basis for creating educated and skilled citizens that holds high the values of equality, fairness, and accountability. It is a tool for identifying national priorities and appropriate policies with which to achieve those priorities. For research system to play an effective and proactive role in the country's development, equity must be its foundation and guiding principle. Our knowledge ecosystem in which research happens must integrate the diverse needs of people across different socioeconomic and political status. We must finely tune our process of knowledge production, from our infrastructures to our research production and dissemination, with the needs of marginalized groups among our society, not as an afterthought, but as an integral component. Our research agendas must always be informed by our local priorities so that our policies are grounded in the needs and aspirations of communities that our policy should always aim to serve. Distinguished guests and participants, the government of Ethiopia has made multiple efforts to strengthen the country's research system. Ethiopia is also implementing its fifth medium-term education sector development plan, which we call ESDP5, that aims to address the main challenges in Ethiopia's education system, one of which is ensuring equity. Between 2000 and 2013, Ethiopia has increased the share of its budget allocation to education from 15% to 27%. In 2015, the government established the Science and Technology Research Council, which aims to identify national research priorities and supports researchers to conduct research accordingly. Another example is the development of a strategy to improve the national agriculture research system, which has led to the establishment of an autonomous Ethiopian Agriculture Research Council in 2013 to coordinate and govern agricultural research at a national level. The strategic document has also identified the absence of a national research database as one of the main challenges to growth of agricultural research in the country. It's clear that research databases required not just for agricultural research, and the Ministry of Science and Higher Education is in the process of establishing a repository whereby at least abstracts of all research conducted at higher education institutions are deposited for wider access. To realize this initiative, the Ethiopian Education and Research Network, abbreviated as ETERNET, which was established with the purpose to build stable, reliable, flexible, modular, and scalable network infrastructure across the country, and to connect our higher education institutions to the global research community, is given the assignment. In this context, we want all stakeholders to contribute their share and also to make use of the repository's resources when it starts to function. Ladies and gentlemen, while progress in Ethiopia has been commendable, it is also important to acknowledge the gap in achieving equity at all levels, especially in the context of our research and knowledge system. Ethiopia's research system is characterized by power imbalances, both at national and international levels. Research topics are often influenced by the interests of researchers and funders. And the research allocation in research is not meaningfully mindful of local priorities. There are pervasive imbalances in access to research outputs. Research outputs are usually published in local and international journals based on the global interests of the subject and in a language that is not accessible to the vast majority of Ethiopians. In Ethiopia, research is primarily conducted by higher learning and research institutions. Research undertaken by universities is fragmented and at times suffers from duplication across universities. Recently, universities have introduced thematic research scheme to align research undertaken at universities with development needs of the country. However, more needs to be done to strengthen the capacity of emerging researchers at universities, especially at third and fourth generation universities, which are very young. The challenge of inequity becomes glaring when looking at gendered inequalities in our education and research system. There is still a large gender gap in enrollment among males and females in higher education. In 2014, gross enrollment rate in tertiary education was at 10% for males, while it was at 5.2% for females. It should be noted that females drop out of school at significantly higher numbers than males do. Women have low representation in academia, which limits their access to capabilities and the resources that could advance their research careers. The lack of women in research and education also means fewer role models or mentors that could best understand gendered experiences and guide the career trajectory of aspiring researchers. Recently, the government of Ethiopia has formed a gender-balanced cabinet, as you remember, and appointed the first female president and also the first female Supreme Court head, an unprecedented step in the country's history. While there is still a lot to be done across all sectors at all levels in ensuring equality and equity, this serves as an apt reminder that if there is a strong will, choice, and commitment, fast and equitable change is within reach. We must ensure that our research and knowledge system is characterized by a mutually productive collaboration between funders and the research institutions. We must nurture the capacity of our researchers through mentorship project programs and put in place appropriate incentive schemes to enhance the visibility and accessibility and applicability of their research outputs. We must strive towards achieving a research system where researchers have a fair access to opportunities irrespective of their differences in gender, other socioeconomic and political standings. Addressing inequalities in our research systems therefore requires holistic and multiple-tiered interventions at the level of policies right down to its translation into practice. It requires engaging with diverse and multiple voices to better understand our context, our challenges, our needs, and ambitions. Ensuring equity at its core entails redistribution of resources, and it is worth pointing out the importance of reflecting on and challenging our long-held conceptions and biases. Ensuring equity requests a coordinated and sustained effort from a multitude of stakeholders and partners in Ethiopia's research and education system. The Ethiopian Academy of Sciences, as an institution entrusted with advancing scientific knowledge and providing evidence-based advice, has been engaged in several endeavors related to strengthening Ethiopia's research and knowledge system. some notable contributions of the academy in this regard include, as already mentioned by Professor Masresha this morning, one, proposing the establishment of a national research council and framework required; two, development of strategy for standardizing, evaluation and accreditation of scholarly journals in Ethiopia, and proposing an institutional mechanism to oversee the accreditation of journals; and finally, the third, provision of training on online journal management to journal editors and managers in collaboration with sister academies.